So, on lap one of the rookie race, we can see here Schumacher starting from the pole. Kilkariki starting alongside him, and they all get away well into turn one. It's reasonably grid order through the first few turns. But we're going to see Kilkariki attacking Schumacher for the lead soon, and he'll never look back from there. Coming off the hairpin, Kilkariki gets a good run to the inside, and he makes the pass stick, and as you can see, Schumacher gets out of rhythm, and Heavenham passes him too for the second position. We'll stick on board with Schumacher for the rest of the lap, and watch how it unfolds. There's Kilkariki putting away at the front, Schumacher perhaps going to have an attack on Heavenham, but can't quite make it stick. We can see Jono and Shaitan battling in the background for the fourth position. And watch as Schumacher comes around this final chicane into the rock, losing lots of positions, three positions there. And he'd have to battle back from this all race. Here's a incident that happened in the middle of the field between Drago and Didi Didi. Watch as Didi Didi disconnects and hits straight into Drago before spinning into the midfield. Really disappointed for both Didi Didi and for Drago, who was affected surely quite a bit by him. Here's Deluxe getting crashed into a tree. He crashes into the tree of his own accord, but then gets hit into it and almost pinned to the tree by Sam, who was running wide. Not really Sam's fault, but still disappointing for Deluxe, who loses a lot of time. Lap 2, and Schumacher, it goes wide, and Exile will get past him. So Schumacher, things are going from bad to worse after starting from the pole position, losing lots of positions, and Didi Didi there, we can see, is disconnecting in the middle of the infield. Luckily, not in harm's way, not causing any dangers to the racers, as the battle between Exile and Schumacher continues. Exile gets past Schumacher again, repassing, making lots of mistakes. It looks like if we get a race like this in the pro race with all these mistakes, passing and repassing, we could have a really, really good race. As we could see there, Schumacher having a look to the inside of Exile off the hairpin, but not quite working. And now having a look to the outside, down the long back straight, and down this, round this curving straight, once again to the outside, and manages to make it stick this time. So really having a great battle early on in this race between Schumacher and Exile. On to lap 4 then, and Shaitan, who had very low fuel from qualifying, will pit. After a great start up to the 4th position, he has to drop all the way back down through the field, but really had a good start from Shaitan. And Jordy would try to battle back from that early fuel problem. Here is Schumacher now battling back up through the field, trying to pass Jacob now, and putting the pressure on, and Jacob makes a mistake and goes wide. You can see here Jacob perhaps either demotivated by the problem, or perhaps he broke something on his car. He then has to retire from the race, which is a shame for him. Perhaps he had lag issues and that was just the key to retiring. Moving on now to lap 11, and here is Cunningham diving up the inside of Schumacher into the hairpin, deciding it was unfair, and like a true gentleman racer, letting him back past. Really good fair play racing from Cunningham there, letting him back past after a slightly unfair overtake. Jono goes to the pits then on lap 11, losing positions to Exile in the process, but now he's turned to set some fast laps, and he comes out in front of Shaitan, which is very crucial for his race. Shaitan and Jono are going to have a great battle over the following laps as well. Moving onwards to lap number 12, and our leader Kilkariki is in the pits. Kilkariki has a good lead because of course Deluxe there we saw going past is a lap down already after his incident early, perhaps damaged his car or damaged his confidence. As Shaitan and Jono continue their great battle through this turn 1, 2 and 3 complex, which I love. It's just fantastic how three corners link together. Now through the sweeping turn 4, turn 5, and then up the hill to the hairpin. Now back down to this corner, which Jono overtakes Shaitan in. Good pass from him, but Shaitan did give him a lot of room. And now Shaitan getting back at Jono, but Jono just holding Shaitan up perfectly there in those corners. Let's forward all the way forward to lap 24. Schumacher on the inside of Shaitan, and Shaitan will run wide and lose that position. Schumacher battling back up the field after taking the pole position but having an awful start. And our leader Kilkariki also in on this lap, fueling up for 27% fuel, so doing probably a 2 or a 3 stopper. In the end, he did indeed do a 3 stop strategy to win this race, but talk is perhaps of 4 stop strategies in the pro race. We don't really know, but it's possible because of this fast pit lane. It's really a fast entry, and you don't lose much time by pitting. There's Shaitan proving once again his gentleman rules and his great fair play values when he blocks Exile just a little bit and lets him back pass, but only to pass him back again nearer to the end of that after Exile makes a mistake. Really good battling between Exile and Shaitan as Drago we see coming to the pits. Now, Drago came out of the pits in front of Exile when Exile pitted, so Exile had to battle back past Drago as we saw it there. Now moving on to lap 36, and Exile battling once again with Drago, getting held up by a lapped car. That's Dylan, who caused a lot of problems for a lot of people in this race. So Dylan, perhaps we won't see him again in the rookie race for a while. Lap 37 out of 39, we're starting to close in at the end, and Shimek is going after the podium position from Jono. Jono driving a great race so far to the podium, but Shimek of course wants it, and we can see the rookie inexperience there for Jono as he goes ploughing into a rock. Not good at all for his position, but he ended up managing to keep the fourth. And here is Kilkariki winning the race in a very weird fashion. The only mistake he made all race really, crashing into a rock as he comes over into the final chicane, and really slowing down to really take in the atmosphere of the win, winning the rookie race. So there's confirmation, Kilkariki wins the rookie race even after that crash into a rock by about 9.5 seconds. He had almost a 12 second lead before that final lap. Shimek all the way back down, 27 seconds down, just managed to get Jono at the end when Jono made that inexperienced mistake. And Drago is the first person on lap down for the DP team, the only surviving DP member now, of course. Exile is 6th place for the plus team, well, his points won't really count for the plus team. Shaitan is in 7th position, Super Pippo 9th, Deluxe 10th, Didi Didi 11th, Sam in 12th, Dylan in 13th, Gabriel in 14th, and Jaycock finishes 15th after his early retirement. So next up is the pro race.
Yeah, the American Grand Prix, and here we go.
The lights are on, Pablinho ready, and we're all away in the US Grand Prix. Pablinho gets a good start, Eddie is coming through in second, and they're all grid order through turns 1, 2 and 3. Mike Nike is making up a position past Pingu, and they're all going to go through the hairpin. Will they all get through here safely? No, there's a crash at the back. Kinda Musty is off the track. Kinda Musty losing loads of position there from his 9th spot on the grid. And Dede is going past Eddie.
Yeah, Eddie having lots of trouble here in the middle sector. And seems that he has lost his position.
Yeah, Dede gets past him there. But Pablinho is running away at this start. Already has quite a lead.
Yeah, and Edmil also keeping up with the leading trio here.
Yeah, that's true. Edmil, after his great 4th position. Pretty much grid order then after the start. Pablini obviously sets the fastest lap. I see Dede gains from the start. Eddie now going back past Dede. And here's Edmil going to maybe try on Dede. No?
Not yet.
Hairpin they go. And Edmil pulls to the inside. Will Edmil make up the position? Yes!
Wow!
Forces it.
That was an astounding move. Just a Bayduk move. Brilliant.
Really forced his way past on under the break in there. And now Edmil's going to go past Eddie, and also Dede will go past Eddie. Eddie runs wide there out of onto the back straight. And now Eddie perhaps
So in one or two corners it seems that Eddie has lost 2 positions and Edmil is already up to 2nd.
We saw that Eddie made up another pass back with Dede, so surely setting up for a good battle in this race between Eddie and Dede. Eddie now leads Dede, and here is our leader Pablinho already making a gap. Just incredible what pace he has. Sometimes when he's just on it, he's on it. And here's Dede and Eddie battling again. Dede to the inside, gets back past, and is Eddie going to have a try? See, I said this track, it's brilliant for side-by-side racing. It really is. And now Mike Nike is all over the back of Eddie. Will Mike Nike have a battle here? No, doesn't quite have the speed. Will he perhaps here? No.
Doesn't seem so.
Yeah, finding it a bit harder to close up than they were earlier. But here's a replay off the start. You can see in slow motion, Edmil gets a really good getaway, actually, doesn't he? And Mike Nike, watch here, he's the only guy to really make up a position on the start. Mike Nike will get past Bingu. Apart from that, they're all grid order through the first turns. Here's the kind of musty crash. Well, here's the Pingu versus Mike. Mike getting past Pingu after Pingu obviously got back past him. And oh, Pingu going a little bit wide, a little bit of a touch with Lex.
Lex and Palm having some problems there on the sand.
Yeah, and Pingu defended very heavily from Lex, as he has every right to, of course. And Lex is just going to power around the outside on that long sweeping straight. And then going to battle again.
Yeah, but Pingu is all over him and going to the inside. Can he make a move?
Yes.
Yes, he can.
Good move
into the top one.
And here is the kind of musty crash then. Let's see what happened here. Oh yes, Matic got into Wokinger, who got into Kaida and Kaida went shooting off. So really that was Matic's fault, you have to say.
He was probably trying to avoid bumping any cars in front of him.
Yeah, perhaps. And here's that Dede getting past Eddie for second place there. And here is the move by Etmil. So he's not really got the speed off the corner, but he just dives to the inside. He's not quite alongside, but he just makes the brakes work much later, and he gets past. Good move from Etmil there. And here's some battling further down in the pack in the midfield, and ooh, both Hazard and John 5 go off. So that's and Whiplash right off there. Whiplash right down to 19th place for the Extreme team, and oh, he's going to retire. Maybe he broke something on the car.
Having some steering problems, perhaps.
Yeah.
No, just sitting on the sand.
Yeah, just like we saw in the rookie race, actually, someone went off wide onto the sand and lost a lot of positions. So, here we are, it's lap 4. Pablino sets another fastest lap at the front, already has a 2.3 second lead over Etmil, who is only in front of Dede by 0.2 seconds. Here is that battle for the second place, but Pablino is pulling away at the front of this Grand Prix. And is Eddie going to try back up the inside of Dede? No, he looks at the outside. Now to the inside, putting the pressure on Dede. Fantastic battle in these early laps between Eddie and Dede. This circuit really proving that it's great for some side-by-side racing. And now Eddie went wide again at the very same corner, and Mike Nike dives up the inside. Mike Nike takes the position away. So Mike Nike now is up to the fourth position. And here is Dede going to go to the inside of Etmil. Etmil defends. Dede squeezes through in the inside into turn one. Fantastic pass. That was unbelievable. If you thought that Etmil's pass on Dede was good, well, that was even better.
Yeah, very, very unexpected for Etmil there.
Yeah, the door, he was trying to close it, but Dede was already there. Fantastic pass. Will the battle between those two continue, just as it continued between him and Eddie earlier in this race? As they battle past Whiplash's stopped car. And Mike Nike having to defend heavily against Eddie. Eddie's going to dive up the inside. Wow. Eddie, later on the brakes. Already in 5 laps of this US Grand Prix, we've seen more overtakes than we saw in the whole Argentinian Grand Prix.
Yeah, indeed.
Absolute exhilarating start here, and Etmil's trying past Dede again. Etmil's got some real pace here today.
Yeah, he's all over Dede right now.
Yeah, these two, it seems one of them passes, speeds up, tries to repass, and the cycle begins again, and Dede goes wide, and Etmil's around the outside.
Wow.
Great. Wow. Here. And ooh, Dede looking to the outside, but goes right on the sand. He's actually lost a bit of time there.
So Etmil's already, again, back up to second.
Oh, do you see that? Lance and Kainer Musty. Kainer Musty, all the way back up to 10th. Great. Lance seemed to try to get to the inside, and then Kainer Musty went sliding, and Lance went off the sand. So both of them losing out there. Kainer Musty after his awful crash.
And another fastest lap by Pablino. Seems that he's having a trouble-free race.
For 2.6 seconds now, the gap between him and Etmil. Just building a gap. Building it up, and really, really showing that he is the man to beat at the moment. Of course, Dede leads the championship, but Pablino is fast catching. If he won this race, then he would only be within 10, 15 points of him, when it, depending where Dede finishes.
And there goes Dede, again, for the third time.
And Dede again goes past Etmil, yes.
Wow.
These two passing and repassing as we rejoin the other battle between Mike Nike and Eddie. There's battles happening all over the track. There's so many that I actually missed that overtake, and I had to make sure my co-commentator saw it. So Dede back past Etmil. And
yeah, we have to see if Etmil can bounce back for the third time. I mean, it's unlikely though, but I have to see. The gap is like 0.4 of a second, I think, yeah?
Yeah, so that's about half a second, really, this sort of gap that we see. And